Welcome to another episode of the MetaTrader tutorial by FBS. This video will look closely at various order types in MT5. An order is a set of instructions from a trader to their broker to purchase or sell an asset on the trader's behalf. If you trade online, you will likely place your orders via an online trading system, in this case, the MetaTrader platform. Traders use different orders depending on their style, experience, and trading strategy. A market order is your best option to buy or sell instantly at the current market price. For example, the gold price might rise rapidly and you want to buy it as soon as possible. To do this, you'd place a market order and buy gold within a millisecond. A stop order is an order to buy or sell an asset at the market price once it reaches a specified price, usually referred to as the stop price. With a stop loss order, a trading position will close if the price goes in the opposite direction. A stop loss order basically guarantees that if the market moves against expectations, you won't lose more than a certain amount you specify yourself. For example, a trader who buys Apple stock at $134.50 per share might set a stop loss order at $124.50. This would limit investment risks to a maximum loss of $10 per share. If the stock price falls to $124.50 per share, the order is executed and the trade is closed. Stop loss orders can be beneficial during essential events and substantial price movement against the trader's position. With a take profit order, a trading position will close if the price goes in a favorable direction. A take profit order allows you to fix a profit even if you're not at your trading desk. If you buy an Apple stock at $134.50 per share, you can set a take profit order to sell shares at $160 if the price goes up. If the stock price reaches $160 per share, the order is automatically executed and the trade is closed. A pending order is an instruction to buy or sell an instrument when its price reaches a certain level. Pending orders fall into three categories: limit orders, stop orders, and stop limit orders. A limit order is when you buy or sell an asset with a restriction on the maximum price to be paid or the minimum price to be received. A limit order may fit if you want to buy at a price lower than the current market price or sell at a price higher than this current price. If filled, the order will only be at the specified limit price or better. However, an order is not necessarily executed, as the market price might never reach a trader's limit order. A limit order is placed immediately after being submitted, and is filled if the asset price exceeds the specified limit. This chart shows a last trade price of roughly $134.80. If you wanted to buy or sell an asset as quickly as possible, you would place a market order, mostly executed immediately at or near the stock's current price of $134.80, which is the blue line here. If you wanted to buy the dropping asset at $124.50, you would place a buy limit order with a limit price of $124.50, the green line. If the stock falls to $124.50 or lower, the limit order will be triggered and executed at $124.50 or below. If the stock cannot fall to $124.50 or below, the order will not be executed. If you wanted to sell the rising stock at $138, you would place a sell limit order with a limit price of $138, the red line. If the stock reaches $138 or higher, the limit order will be triggered and executed at $138 or above. If the stock cannot rise to $138 or above, no execution will occur. A stop order is an order to buy or sell an asset at the market price once it reaches a specified price, known as the stop price. You would typically set a sell stop order below the current market price. An order triggers when the market price drops at or below a stop price. Once this happens, the stop order will be activated and become a market order, selling the asset at the market's current price. The order won't be executed if an asset fails to reach the stop price. A stop order can also be used to buy. Set this order above the current market price. When the market price rises to or above a stop price, the order triggers and turns into a market order, buying the asset at the market's current price. In a rapidly changing market, a stop order may not be filled at the exactly specified price level, but is usually filled relatively close to it. In some extreme situations, however, stop loss orders cannot provide much protection. The best way to understand a stop limit order is to break it into parts. The stop price acts as a trigger to place a limit order. When the market reaches the stop price, the broker automatically creates a limit order with a custom price. Although the stop and limit prices can be the same, they don't have to be. It's safer to set the stop price a bit higher than the limit price for sell orders. Set the stop price for buy orders slightly lower than the limit price. This increases the chances of your limit order filling after it triggers. Suppose gold is currently at 1914 and you would like to buy it when it moves up. However, if it quickly begins to rise, you only want to pay a little for the gold, so you need to limit the price you will pay. Suppose your technical analysis shows an uptrend might start if the market breaks above 1928. However, you prefer to avoid trading a fake breakout and use a buy stop limit order to open a position in the breakout case. You set your stop price at 1928 and your limit price at 1935. As soon as gold reaches 1928, a limit order to buy gold at 1935 will be placed. Your order might be filled for 1935 or lower. Considering your limit price is 1935, if the market exceeds this price too quickly, your order might be only partially filled. Suppose you bought gold at 1860, and it is now at 1913. If the price drops back to your entry, you use a stop limit order to prevent losses to sell gold. You set up a sell stop limit order with a stop price of 1870 and a limit price of 1860, the price you purchased the gold at. If the price reaches 1870, a limit order to sell gold at 1860 will be placed. If the price reaches 1860, your order might be filled at 1860 or higher. A trailing stop order is a standard stop order modification set at a certain percentage or amount of points away from the current market price. For a long position, an investor places a trailing stop loss below the current market price. For a short position, an investor places the trailing stop above the current market price. A trailing stop is designed to protect gains by keeping a trade open as long as the price moves in the trader's favor. The order closes the trade if the price changes direction by a specified percentage or points amount. A trailing stop is usually placed at the same time the initial trade is placed, although it may also be placed after the trade. Thank you for watching, and see you in the next episode of the FBS MetaTrader tutorial.